We've already considered some of the theory of comparative advantage, so now let's take a look at the evidence on gains from trade. Plenty of articles show that trade and economic growth are positively correlated, that is, they move together. But it's hard to separate out how much is trade causing growth or how much is growth causing trade. So ideally what we would like is some kind of natural experiment where there is an exogenously given increase in the amount of trade, and then we can see how much economic output responds. And for such an experiment, we can turn to the earlier history of Japan. Japan had instituted fairly tight seclusion policies since 1639. In part, they were afraid of imperialism, and also they were afraid that Christianity would obtain a foothold in their country. So for over two centuries, there was really just a very small amount of foreign trade entering Japan. But then, for political reasons, come 1859, Japan is suddenly opened up to trade, and after that point, trade is mostly free. This is possibly the kind of natural experiment we've been looking for. One benefit of the new trade is that Japan was able to export to the rest of the world, and at that time the two most significant Japanese exports were tea and silk. The new trade is also a story about imports. For instance, in Europe, due to the Industrial Revolution, cotton textiles had become much cheaper than they were in much of Asia. Iron production also was much more efficient in, say, England than in Japan at the time. Japan was able to gain from trading for the goods, but also over time trading for those technologies. Japan was also able to import a lot of new goods that they simply hadn't had before, and this includes glass, boots, butter, woolens, and also muskets. So the question asked in one research paper is this: for the years 1851 to 1853, how much extra income for Japan would in fact be equal to the gains from trade that Japan enjoyed from opening up trade with the rest of the world? In essence, this question is trying to measure the benefits from the much freer trade. A simple way to think about what's going on is that we're trying to add up the gains from the Japanese exports, and then sum those with the ability to bring in cheaper imports, again, through trade. These measures, of course, are somewhat inexact. For instance, measuring the value of exports and imports is based on market prices, but market prices, as we know, they only measure value at the margin for the final increment of a good or service which is traded in the market. Also, this is a study of the middle of the 19th century, and the data are to some extent incomplete or imperfect. Finally, it is hard to value new goods using this method. So we do have data on the price of new goods in the post-trade regime, but from that we're somehow trying to extrapolate what was the value of those new goods in the pre-trade regime, and that can be hard to do. Still, for all of these problems, we are getting some reasonable measure of the gains from freer trade here. And what is found in the study is this, that there is an upper bound which we can measure on the gains from trade, and that upper bound at the time was about 8 to 9% of Japan's GDP. Perhaps most importantly, there is a longer-term dynamic gain from having this trade, that is, over time it enabled Japan to develop and become a modern country, as for instance is shown here. This is a picture of Yokohama and Mount Fuji. Had Japan not opened itself up to trade, this eventual brighter future for Japan probably would not have been possible. And this is not captured in that number, that upper bound of 8 to 9% of GDP. The main results here are drawing on a very good and important research paper by Daniel Bernhofen and John Brown, and that is called Empirical Assessment of the Comparative Advantage Gains from Trade, Evidence from Japan. Those same two writers have another piece, somewhat more technical, called A Direct Test of the Theory of Comparative Advantage, The Case of Japan. If you'd like to read about the history of Japan's opening up to trade with the outside world, one place you could start is simple to Google, Opening of Tokugawa, Japan.